In the next three videos, we are going to discuss some basic implementations of the inverter technology. In particular, in this video, the HBridge inverter will be presented. More in depth, we will go through the topology of the HBridge inverter, the components that form this power electronic device, the modes of operation that are usually employed to pass from DC to AC power, and finally, we are going to have a quick look at the three-phase topology of the HBridge inverter. The HBridge presents four switches named from S1 to S4. The name of this type of converter is given by the typical shape which resembles the letter H. The load here is situated in the middle between the four switches. Typically, the basic components of this converter are the switches that can be IGBTs, MOSFETs or thyristors, feedback diodes anti-parallel to the switches, inductor and capacitor that act as a filter at the inverter output. The anti-parallel diodes are included in the design in order to avoid that damage due to reverse overcurrent occurs on the switching devices. A basic example of operation of the H-bridge is rather similar to the one seen in the DC-DC converter topologies. There are two possible switching states. Either S1 and S4 are closed, and S2 and S3 are open, or S1 and S4 are open, and S2 and S3 are closed. When S1 and S4 are closed or switched on, the current ID will start flowing through them and passing through the load. Let's now visualize how the load voltage Vout changes with time. When S1 and S4 are closed, the voltage has positive polarity and equals the input voltage. When there is a commutation between the two switch pairs, S1 and S4 are switched off, while S2 and S3 are switched on, almost instantly. The current will start to flow through S2 and S3 and again into the load. In this case, the voltage will be again equal to the input voltage, but of inverse polarity. This cycle goes on, giving the typical square wave output voltage. A DC-AC converter is capable of switching between two states, logically speaking, between 0 and 1. This means that, as we have seen in the previous slide, the real output will be always a pulsed wave. However, the desired output voltage of the inverter is a sinusoidal signal. To determine the active power carried by a square wave signal, Fourier analysis is used, and it allows to describe a periodic signal as the sum of an arbitrary number of sine and cosine functions. If the output signal is an odd function, the first or fundamental harmonic is a pure sine. This is the only harmonic that carries active power. On the other hand, the harmonics of a higher order generate a distortion in the signal and therefore need to be filtered out by a low-pass filter. Here we can see the third harmonic in red and the fifth harmonic in blue. Summing these three harmonics, we obtain an approximation of the original square wave. Adding up more harmonics makes the approximation more accurate. A triphase inverter shows a switching section consisting of six switches, coupled again with the feedback diodes placed anti-parallel to the device. Three lines are drawn for the three phases of the output voltage, after which are usually placed inductive coils in series and a capacitor bank in parallel that can work as a low-pass filter. As seen before, this filter is fundamental to reduce the harmonic distortion of the output waveform. Unlike the DC-DC topologies with only one switch, the presence of multiple switches allows to have more combinations and different output shapes given by the different duty ratios. One of the most used switching strategies is the pulse width modulation, or PWM, that we are going to deal with more extensively in the next video. If the power converted from DC to AC is less than 100 kilowatts, the switching devices used are usually self-commutated ones. Among these devices, we can mention the IGBT, the MOSFET, and the GTO. These devices are characterized by very fast switching and feature a controller that takes care of the opening and closing of the transistors. When it comes to power ratings higher than 100 kilowatts, line-commutated semiconductor devices such as thyristors are used. Unlike self-commutated devices, thyristors need an input signal, usually retrieved from the grid, to start conducting. This option is typically employed for high voltage DC and high voltage AC applications. To sum up, we saw that a HBridge DC to AC converter is composed by switches, feedback diodes, inductor and capacitor. We also saw that the output waveform of the inverter is a pulse train that can be decomposed in a low frequency sine wave called the fundamental harmonic, and other higher frequency sine waves are referred to as higher order harmonics. The square wave can be reconstructed by summing all its harmonics. Finally, we saw the typical topology of a triphase inverter. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.